सो मयूरी, आर यू रेडी विथ योर सेमिनार?
यस मैम।
ओके, सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम वी शुड स्टार्ट अवर सेमिनार।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू रिस्पेक्टेड प्रोफेसर एंड ऑल माय डियर बैचमेट्स। आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज सेमिनार। आई एम मयूरी राजपूत एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज सेमिनार इज मीनिंग एंड डेफिनेशन ऑफ क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट व्हिच इज फ्रॉम आवर कोर्स 201 दैट इज क्वालिटी एंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन। I would like to thank you, our professor Pratibha ma'am, for guiding me for this seminar. Ma'am, next slide.
Just wait.
Okay. So in today's seminar, we are going to cover these points. The first one, what is the concept of quality, definition of quality, dimensions of quality, then the concept of management, definition of management, levels of management, and the meaning and definition of quality management. So let's start with our topics. Ma'am, next slide, please. So
yes.
First topic is quality. Here I want answer from your side. That when we listen the word quality, what do you think? Which is the first thing comes in your mind? Anyone from your side, please reply. Hello?
Yes, student, please answer.
No one. Okay. So when we usually think about this term quality, it is in terms of the excellent product or service that fulfill our expectations. Okay. Or we can say when a product fulfill, what are the expectations, what the customer is willing from the product and the product is fulfilling that particular thing, then we can say the product is having a quality. Okay. Ma'am, next slide, please. Here are a few definitions of quality. Quality means meeting the customer needs or requirement. Whatever the requirements or needs of a customer from a product, if that product is fulfilling that particular requirements and needs, it means the product is having a quality. Ability of a product and service to fulfill the customer needs. The same thing. Whatever the needs or requirements from the customer side, if that product is completing or that product is fulfilling that, so we can say that the product is having the quality. Capability of a product or service to knowingly satisfy wants of user. Whatever the user wants from the particular product, if that product is having the capability of completing that requirement, then we can say that the product is having the quality. The next one is the standard of something as measured against the other thing of similar kind. Here we can say if there are two products of similar kind, if we take the example of pencil or we take the example of any clothes like kurta, if and we compare both, that one of it is having a very good quality. Its color is fresh and decent. Its material is good. In compare with that, the another kurta, which is not having a good fabric or a faded color. So it means the standard of something is measured against the other things of similar kind. Two same things, but they are having the different standards. The degree of excellence of something. The degree of excellence of something means any object or anything which is how much it is excellent for its purpose, for whatever purpose that product is designed, how much it is excellent, how much it is meeting the excellency. That is, we can say a quality. Then the degree to which set of inherent characteristics fulfill the requirement. It means the degree of fulfilling the characteristics if anything is there and what are the characteristics that all the characteristics are meeting by that particular thing, then that thing we can say it is a qualitative, or we can say there is a quality in that particular thing. So the quality in a product or service is not what the supplier puts in, it is what the customer gets out and is willing to pay for. This is the definition given by the Peter Drucker. So according to Peter Drucker, it's quality means it is not like whatever the services or what the supplier is putting in that. When we say that the product is product is having quality, when only the customer gets what he wants and what he is paying for. Okay, ma'am, next slide please. So how can we measure the quality? Or we can say these are the dimensions, few dimensions of the quality. So the first dimension of the quality is performance. So this is the very primary thing, performance, that particular how what is the basic requirement of the product. This is the comes under this dimension. If we take the example of pen, what is the basic requirement, or we can say what is the primary thing which we want from the pen, that when we write it works flawlessly. This is the, if it is flawlessly writing, if that pen is giving the flawless writing, we can say that the pen is quality pen, pen is having the quality. Now the next one is features. So in features, this is the secondary part of that particular thing, or we can say this is the secondary part of that particular product. Secondary characteristics are added, we can say the features of that particular product. If it is meeting the features of the product, then we can say that the product is the having the quality. Then the next dimension is conformance. Conformance means the meeting the specifications. With every product, if we purchase anything from the market, we got manual with that. Okay, and in that manual, the specifications are given. What are the things provided, or what are the characteristics of this particular product? So the conformance means the meeting that particular specifications given by the organization. The next dimension of the quality is the reliability. So in this, we can say that the consistency or the performance of the product, how much it is consistent, and it shows then the that the product is the quality product. Then the next one is the durability. Durability means how much how long time you can use that particular product. Okay, this also decides the quality of the product. Then the next dimension is service. So if you need in future, if you need the repair or something for a particular product, then what is the ratio of resolution of that problem for that particular service center, or how that organization is giving you taking your complaint, how much it is easy for you to repair that particular product. So this all comes under this dimension, service. So the next one is the next dimension is response. This is depends person to person, how the person is, sorry, this response is how the treatment is given from the organization, that whenever customer is asking for that particular thing, or asking for the information about that particular thing, how the organization is responding. So this is the one dimension of the quality, that is response. The next one is the aesthetic. In this, the we can say the sensory characteristics, we can say as the exterior finishing of the product, like touch and feel of the product, how it is, if it is nice, then we can say that it is the quality. So this is one of aesthetic is one dimension of the quality. And the next one is the reputation. How is the reputation of that particular product in the market? Or we can say, if we compare the two products of same kind, then how much it is reputed? That is also the one dimension of the quality. Okay, ma'am, next slide, please. This is all about quality. Now, if we measure the quality in the quantitative term, so we can give it as Q is equals to P upon E. It is the ratio of performance and expectations. Q is the quality, P stands for performance, and E stands for the expectation. Here, if the ratio, here, if we say that performance is greater than the expectation, we can say there is the quality. Okay, we can say the quality is good. But if the expectations are greater than the performance, then we can say there is no quality or less quality, or we can say that the product is not fulfilling the quality term. In this way, we can calculate the quality. Ma'am, next slide, please. This is all about the term quality. Now, with this picture, what do you think what this picture is showing? Can anybody give answer? Okay. So, hello. Hello.
Yes.
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, yes, Mayuri,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, you're audible. Please. Hello.
Okay. Thank you.
Please continue.
Okay. Okay. So in this picture, there is a success and there is a team that is going toward the success. And there are various team members. They are approaching toward the success, but with the by coordinating each with each other with the various tasks. So here the concept of the management, I'm going to explain how it comes and how it arises. A few years back, or we can say 20 to 40 years, 20 years back, the competition increases in the various countries, and then this concept of management arises. So this word management comes from the word management, which means the art and leading. We use this concept in our daily life also, in various places we can see the concept of management, like hospitals, various systems are there where we can use this concept of the management. Ma'am, next slide, please. Here are a few definitions of management. Management means to manage is to forecast and plan, to organize, to compound, to coordinate, and to control. This definition is given by the Henry Fayol. So according to the Henry Fayol, what is the meaning of to manage? To manage means is to forecast and plan. Forecast means to predict and then plan according to the prediction of that particular things. And to organize. To organize means whatever you are, whatever plan is there in your mind, to organize that plan in a proper way. To compound, to divide the work between the people, and to coordinate and to control. And after dividing this particular things, coordinate towards the plan. So this is by Henry Fayol. Then by Mary Parker Follett, it is management is getting things done through the According to her, the management means the things getting done along with the people or with the help of the other people. Then by F.W. Teller, it is management is the art of knowing exactly what you want to do and then seeing that it is done in the best and cheapest way. Management is the art, according to the Teller. He said that this is the art. And what is the art about? It means in this art, you have to know what exactly you want. And accordingly, you can do the plannings and accordingly, you can do the, you can perform the actions to what exactly you want that you will get at the best way and in the cheapest way. Next slide, please. Here are a few more definitions by the Peter Drucker. Management is a function, a tactic, discipline to help managers to carry out the functions and complete the assigned task. Management is a function, a tactic, discipline to help managers to carry out the functions and complete the assigned task. Whatever the task is assigned to that particular person, to that particular manager, this is the plan, or we can say this is the task, this is the work which needs to get complete or get done with the help of that particular plan. According to the Wikipedia, management is a process of combining and coordinating a range of resources, either in the form of money, people, or equipment to complete the organization goals. Whatever the sets, whatever the goals or objectives set by the organization, this to complete that organization, to coordinate and combine all the available resources, then it may be money, it may be people, or it may be equipment, means living or non-living thing, anything to combine them all and do the coordination between them. It all comes under the process. This all we can say a process of the management, or we can say the management. Ma'am, next slide, please. So here are a few levels of management. There are various levels of management, higher level, middle level, and lower level. Here, if we consider the example of school, then at higher level management, we can say the board of directors and managers. At middle level, it is, we can say the supervisors, various leaders, and at the lower level, the workers. It means the non-teaching staff, administration people. This all comes under here in the lower level. At various level, there is the managers we required and management we required. Ma'am, next slide. Now here, the concept of the quality management. The quality management is the act of overseeing all the activities and tasks needed to maintain a desired level of excellence. This is the one kind of act of what is overseeing all the activities. All the activities comes in the management and tasks needed to maintain a desired level of excellence. Excellence maintain karne ke liye, jo bhi activities, tasks jo required hoti hai, that उन सबको मैनेज करना इट वी कैन से दैट इट इज द क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट. दिस क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट एंश्योर दैट एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन प्रोडक्ट और रिक्वायर्स फॉर क्वालिटी इन पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट. दिस क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट एंश्योर दैट देर इज द कंसिस्टेंसी इन दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट विच इज गिवन बाय दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नाउ हाउ दिस क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट अराइजेस, हाउ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट इज अराइजेस, बेसिकली दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज फॉर द प्रीवियसली दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज यूज इन द for the business purpose, like when there was increase in the competition in various countries, and then this concept is arise, how the people are thinking, the businessmen are thinking, how we can use the different tools, different techniques to improve the service, so we can give the quality in our product, and then we satisfy our customers, and automatically the sale of our product will be increased. And so they decided to use this concept of quality management, and then afterwards the business world is following this, the concept of the quality management. And later on, when there is the technological changes, or we can say there is the inventions in technology, this concept also used in the education purpose. So this quality management approach also follows in the education. In educational quality is highly influenced by the learning experience gained by the students during the teaching learning process. See, when students are learning what in school or in institution, in how much, in which type of process they are learning, it influences more on the quality of the education. Ma'am, next slide, please. So here are a few definitions about the quality management. The quality management is the assembly and management of all the activities aimed at the production of quality by organizations of various kinds. This is quality management means it is the assembly and management of all the activities aimed at the production of quality by organization of various kinds. If there is an organization, for example, we consider a school, there are various persons in school, and according to that person, the quality is the different. If for every person, quality means different thing. Like if we consider various pillars of our schools, like students, teachers, management, parents, so for them, quality is different thing for the every person. Like for students, when the school is having quality, when the school is providing the facilities for the students, like it is providing various platforms for various activities, or it's providing various tools for sports, various functions are there, labs are very good, co-curricular and curricular activities are conducting very nicely in the school. So according to the student, that school is school is having quality. But the according to the teachers, what according to the staff, how the school is having quality, the school is having proper management, when the teaching learning process is good, when adequate material for teaching is available, various sources are there for the when there is taking care of teachers or regarding their skill development. So according so the teacher can say there is a quality management in that particular school. What about the parents and management? When the parents see the continuous growth in every section, or we can say the continuous growth of the children or continuous growth of the student in various areas, that time the parents can say the school is having a good quality management. So according to everyone, there is the various term for the quality management, or various meaning for the quality management. This is the assembly and management of all activities, means all the activities aimed at the production of the quality by the organization. Whatever the aims and goals set by the organization to fulfill that aim, to fulfill that goal, whatever the task, whatever the activities are done by the people which comes under management is consider as the quality assembly of that all together. We can say that the management of the quality. The next one is, it is the management activities and functions involved in determination of quality policy and its implementation through means such as quality planning and quality assurance. See, to complete,
Mayuri,
when there's a particular organization, yes, ma'am.
You have only
hello.
Five, you have only 5 minutes now.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
It is a. When organizations set goals and objectives, so accordingly, it needs to set the quality planning and quality assurance, which is the part of the quality management. Now, what is the quality planning and quality assurance? The quality planning means, quality assurance means, whatever goals and objectives are set by the organization, set a particular, a standard plan, or we can say a standard planning for giving that we are giving this, or we are fulfilling these objectives and aims, that is comes under the quality assurance. And to fulfill that particular plan, to come to achieve the goal, whatever actions, actual actions you are taking, that comes under the quality control and quality planning. Next slide, ma'am. Here are a few principles of quality management: that customers focus, leadership, engagement of people, process approach, improvement, evidence-based decision making, relationship management. So basically, the first one is the customer focus. So when we are thinking about the quality management, the focus should be the customer. This organization depends on their customers, and therefore they understand the current and future customer needs, and it, that need should meet customer requirements and strive to exceed the customer expectations. The next one is the leadership. At every level of management, we need the leaders, as they motivate the every person or every staff members, which is to fulfill the objectives and aims set by the organization. The next one is the involvement of people. People at all levels of management are the needs to involve in their works according to their abilities, and they use for the organization's benefit. The next one is the process approach. A desired result is achieved more efficiently when activities are related resources and are managed as a process. A particular process is needed to fulfill the particular aims and objectives of the organization. Then the next one is the system approach to management. Identify, understand, and managing the interrelated processes as a system contribute to the organization's effectiveness and efficiency in achieving its objectives. Next one is the continual improvement. With the help of the feedbacks and all, we can see the continual improvement of the organization's overall performance should be a permanent objective of the organization. And the last one is factual approach to decision making. Effective decisions are based on the analysis of the data and the information. And the last one, mutually beneficial supplier relationship. To maintain the relationship between all the resources, all the persons which are related to the organization is important. So the last one, the conclusion, ma'am, next slide. So at last, what is the quality management? Quality management is the term focused not only on product and service quality, but also on the means to achieve it. The quality to be maintained in a project is decided by the stakeholders, owners, and clients of the project. So basically, overall quality management is not the term which only focus on what the output is getting to the customer, but it is the all the process, or we can say all the objects which are responsible for getting that output. And the quality to be maintained in a project is decided by the stakeholders, owners, and client of the project. It is not only by the customer, but it is also the people who are investing in that, the people who are working for that, and the person who is taking the benefit of that particular thing. Thank you.
Okay, Mayuri, very nicely you have conducted your seminar. First of all, I congratulate you because
thank
in a very short period of time, you have prepared your seminar and given it very nicely.
Thank you, ma'am.
Various points you have completed, covered in your seminar, like what is quality, what are the dimensions of quality, even the concept. The main focus was on the quality management, and for that you gave the different example by considering the all the pillars of the education system. It can be parents, society, students, and the management. Okay.
Yes,
but I was expecting that somewhere you're supposed to give explanation by considering the school education only. So, for example, while explaining the different levels of the management, see, this is visible. So, higher level management,
yes,
who comes under high,
see, yes,
you have to consider about the any organization. Okay. For example, the school. Any secondary school,
yes,
school you can consider. So who came under the higher level, who came under the middle, and who came under the lower level. Okay, so I was expecting this, but it is okay. See, I like this definition. See, quality management is the act of overseeing all the activities. So whenever we are using this overseeing, it's like a supervising, and here we supposed to consider all the things, like whatever activities or whatever tasks taken in the particular school. Apart from that, we have to also consider the human beings, or what we can say, we have to consider the human resources who are going to conduct, or we are going to plan and implement those activities. So here we are thinking about the desired level of excellence, and for that always we are measuring, we are comparing the quality of the particular thing with the standards. Okay. Actually, we have very less time because I have started this meeting on Zoom's platform. Okay, my what?
Actually, ma'am, I was waiting in that Teams meeting.
I have sent link on the group, dear. Okay, no problem. Okay, my question to Mayuri, why quality is dynamic?
Why
quality is dynamic?
Dynamic.
Yes, and my another question is quality planning. What is difference between the quality planning and quality assurance? It was there in your definition. Both the words were there,
yes,
in your definition. Yes. Okay, can you give me any one example of quality assurance? How can you give assurance to the customers? Because here we are considering all the customers, parents, students, society, all these are the customers. So how you can give assurity to
like,
the customers?
Like assurance we can give by showing them plans, like we are having these facilities in our school. We are providing sports facilities for the physical development of the child. We are taking their yoga and meditation sessions. This is for their health regarding. And for development of their academics, we can take various competitive exams, and we are providing guidance. This is our plan. So this comes under the quality assurance.